use to sing a song. Jesus said, here I stand, won't you please let me in? And you said, I will tomorrow. Jesus said, I am he who supplies all your needs. And you said, I know, but tomorrow, ooh, tomorrow, I'll give my life tomorrow. I thought about today, but it's much easier to say tomorrow. Who promised you tomorrow? You better choose the Lord today, for tomorrow very well might be too late. Jesus said, here I stand, won't you please take my hand? And you said, I will tomorrow. Jesus said, I am he who supplies all your needs. And you say, I know, but tomorrow, ooh, tomorrow, I'll give my life tomorrow. I thought about today, but it's much easier to say tomorrow. Who promised you tomorrow? You better choose the Lord today, for tomorrow very well might be too late. And who said tomorrow would ever come for you? Still you laugh and play and continue on to say tomorrow. Forget about tomorrow. Won't you give your life today? Please don't just turn and walk away. Tomorrow, tomorrow is my promise. Don't let this moment slip away, 'cause tomorrow could very well begin today.
Pray as in Psalms 37 that Calvin Frank has a hope of everlasting life and hope still open to live on a paradise earth. And as John the 5th chapter verses 28-29 talks about how Jesus will raise those in a memorial tomb, how they will hear his voice, giving them the hope of a resurrection on paradise earth. And also we have Psalms Revelation chapter 21 verses 3 and 4, how God one day will wipe out the tears from their eyes. There will be no more sorrow, no more pain. And this is a hope that is for all of us, that we can live with no more sorrow. So while Calvin Frank is asleep in death right now, he has a great hope before him to live on a beautiful paradise earth where we can all live, stand, and live in peace. We do pray, come in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. I see some uncles and some aunts that I haven't seen in a while. I wish it was under better circumstances. I'm going to read two verses out of the Bible, which when I read them, it makes me think on how God acts in the beginning, the present, and in the future. The first verse I'm going to read is from Psalms 23:4. Yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. The second verse is from Revelation 21:4. And God shall wipe away all tears from the eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. God has taken my uncle, who is also like a brother. He's been with me and my family since about 81, 82. My mom and dad did a good job with him. He's always been around, and he's never hurt anybody in his life. And I know he died not suffering. He was taken because he was called only God. Thanks, everybody.
Yeah. We think of that. And I'm going to miss that boy. because we grew up together, you know. And he told me, I need a haircut. And Greg and I went up there. But somebody to give him a haircut. You know, I can't say what I want to say. I'm an introvert like Calvin. I do my say by doing, not talking. That's what I like about Calvin. He didn't talk too much. But he knew what to say. But he's love. I love Calvin. Just like my son. But it's hard to know somebody, to lose somebody like Calvin. All I get to do is cry and think, you know, the thing we went through, Calvin and I. And like Leroy said, he's a hustler. He's a hustler. And I'm right there beside him. We used to go hunt junk, you know, like metal and stuff like that. And I said, Calvin, oh, people can have the washing machine, you know, that refrigerator. Now, give me, how much you go? I said, I'm going to give you half the money more than I'm going to give you 10 cents more than I'll make. But he did it. He gave it to me. He did that, and shoot, we did. That's how I made my living when I was young. Hustling. And Calvin was a hustler. He was a hustler. He didn't ask nobody for nothing. He didn't ask nobody but nothing. And you know, Calvin was like me, you know. He was talking in his heart, not his mouth. I have myself do my talking for me. Ray, Gregory, Brian, and you know, I hope you enjoy what they say, you know what I mean? They're speaking through me. Angelo.
Tina.
All of them, you know. They were good kids. They were good kids. It was hard bringing them up, but they were good kids. And, you know, well, that's just going on.
Yes.
Lord have mercy. I hope you don't wait for the near death to go all together. I get together one day, and, you know, I'm just for the heck of it. Because Calvin, he couldn't have his land up there. I know that. Yeah, I know you do that. Because.
But I'm Marie. That's Marie. But I'm Calvin. See, you say he would never say, man, I'm glad he did. Okay, well, I'm 16 years old. We went to Vegas. Me, Uncle Calvin, my daddy, my mama, and children, and Uncle Leroy. We believed me and Uncle Calvin in the car for a long time. He didn't have the key, though. Uncle Calvin said, when he left the key, let's go for a ride. I said, okay, let's go then. We'll get the man. He said, yeah. I said, don't tell him I did then. So we took the ride, and he told me I ought to go find a comb to put in my spider thread. I might not get anything to the spider thread. I couldn't find a comb. So we took the ride in the car. Right, but we made it back just in time, but I couldn't find the same spot. I rubbed it onto the side of a pole. He said, don't tell him Uncle Leroy that a car did.
Nice
to help me, I'm like, you see? 25. But I did know. I confess. I'm with you. But you just tell me what he has. Okay. I love him, and you know I do. Okay? I love all you guys. So, you can grant me.
Okay. You guys say you didn't want to say nothing. But y'all said, Matthew, go get me a beer. Really quick. See how you're looking right now?
Yeah.
You pray there. Where's my beer at?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's
right.
Look at
him.
Look.
That's right.
Hey, go get me one. Don't tell nobody else. Go get me one.
One thing I got to really say about Uncle Kevin, he was cool.
Yes.
Period.
Yes.
One day, they had like a little party at the house.
Tell it, Ray. Come on.
And I had a suit on. Little cardigan suit.
Yeah.
What happened? What you get that suit from? I got it from Willie Bird. He said, I like that suit. I said, you want it? He said, yeah, we trade clothes.
He sure did. Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
And he said, you ain't gonna get it back. Go get us a beer. So every time he's in his room chilling by himself, I don't even know what he wants. We gotta pass the room. Go like this. That's why I'm on the pictures, he's like, where they at? All the pictures. He's like, I need one. But, get a metro. Get that one.
Yes. You bring that one?
Bring it on for Ray.
All right, Ray.
I know, see, a couple of my brothers saying, but you know what? The real singer's up here now. Yeah, it's a cloudy day.
Is that right?
Yeah. It's a cloudy day. What kind of sun do we have?
I've got sunshine. Oh, cloudy day.
When it's cold outside,
I got the month of May. Well, I guess you say, what can make me feel this way?
Calvin,
talking about Calvin, Calvin.
He cleaned them, he painted them, he done everything that I would ask him. Things got rough for us one year. When we first came to California, and Calvin said, "Brother, we know how to make some money." He said, "You got a pickup truck." I got my brother Alvin. And Calvin used to go buy junket. He used to go pick up washing machines, bathtubs, and tear them up, and we go sell them for junk. Mm-hmm. Calvin knew how to strip the washing machine, get all the copper out of it. He showed me how to save beer cans, bottles. And he really helped me and my family, and I missed him so much. And I know he's in a better place now. And I'm always going to have him in my heart. So I just want to thank the Lord for the opportunity, for knowing him and him being a part of my life. And I just want to thank him for being here with us.
Yeah.
Jack Cooper, what's going on? Right, I just want to thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
You don't want me to speak.
Yeah, I say enough is enough about him.
This year he stayed with me 6 weeks. He had a great time. I cooked his favorite meals. He wanted pork rib and rice. I cooked that. He wanted beans and rice. I cooked that. He said the beans wasn't as good as Shirley. So I know now, you know, when he came back, I made sure that I brought that technique with his kids. We had a lovely time. We had a lovely time at Cass and Tom's. Throughout the years, I guess he's been coming to my house at Thanksgiving, oh, probably 15, 16 years. And he would help my husband Jimmy cut the yard, wreck the leaves, and they would have a ball. And one day he told me, he said, "You know what? We wrecked these leaves and put them in the barrel and we had wood hair and throw it in the woods," and he said he'd just come right back up. So why is Jimmy just wrecking the leaves and putting it in the barrel? Gave him a surprise birthday party. And knowing Calvin, he loved people, but he doesn't like a lot of attention. So he was really shocked. Jimmy went to get the cake, and he had to go through the back door, and I was cooking and putting it on the big table. He sat in the front room, and one by one, family started coming in. My sister's children, their children, cousins. And he said, "What's going on?" I thought, I was told he was going to a movie today. He said, "What's going on?" I thought he was going to a movie. "Mom just didn't come see me today." And so he brought out the cake and said, "Happy birthday." And he was really, really thrilled and happy. I'm going to miss Calvin. He loved all of us, and we loved him. I don't know what else to say. I just love so much, but it's all in my heart. And I'm going to miss you, Calvin.
Hi everyone, I am the other Marie. I'm Marina's youngest daughter here with my family. My brother Glenn is here as well. And I want to say a few words about Uncle Calvin. As she said, as many of you said, he's such a wonderful presence. I think Tina said it best when she said, "You had to get him to engage and smile." So her poem and the hat just really resonated with me. And so much of what everyone said. But he's always, you know, been a part of our life. When I saw Uncle Leroy and I saw Aunt Shirley, when Calvin was not far behind me. And Brenda's right, I won't tell you how old I am. But he's always lived with my Uncle Leroy and Aunt Shirley ever since I know. Have known, and even though he would come every year and spend time with us, couldn't wait to get home. So, that's because he knew his love. So,
he was packed to go.
And my mom said, he was, she was with him when he passed. It was a blessing. There were people around who were very helpful to her while he was, being worked on. There was a gentleman in the store that they were in front of, and my mother and Jimmy went to see him recently, and he handed her a poem, and it was just really thoughtful, and we wanted to share it with all of you. and the poem says, it's called I Am With You Still. I give you this thought to keep. I am with you still. I do not sleep. I am the gentle wind that blows. I am the diamond wet in snow. I am the sunlight glow on ripened grain when you wake up in the morning. I am the gentle breeze that touches your cheek. I am the soft light of stars at night. Do not think of me as gone. I am with you still in each new dawn. Love, Jessica.
Today to learn a lesson from Calvin's life.
Yes.
I really do not believe in my heart that Calvin had any bitterness, that he didn't have any anger in his heart. He didn't have any unforgiveness in his heart. I believe that Calvin had a pure heart. And we can learn that lesson today from Calvin, because it's a lesson that is recorded many times in Scripture about let no bitterness, let no anger, let no malice, let no unforgiveness be found in your heart. Because we don't know when our day is coming. We don't know when our hour is coming. The scripture that was read by Kenneth in Revelation that says that all tears will be wiped away from our eyes. That's a good scripture to hang on to.
Amen.
That's a wonderful scripture to hang on to. And that lets us know that this life and the life that he has beyond this life, they are altogether different. Calvin left a good name here. He left an honorable name here. And none of us will ever forget Calvin Frank. And from what I could understand, nobody made him live any different than he wanted to live. If he wanted to get up at 3 o'clock and go to the liquor store, he went. Couldn't stop him, Sheriff couldn't stop him, the law couldn't stop him. Nobody. He did what he wanted to do. Amen. He lived a free, simple,